Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I wanted to wish everybody who is Catholic or who is celebrating Easter right now a very happy celebration. Of course, I realize that you might be in different parts of the world, so you are probably a day behind. Nevertheless, I hope whatever is left of your weekend in progress is as wonderful as possible. And for those who are not Orthodox or are not observing right now, I'm wishing you in advance that you will have a very joyous religious celebration when the time comes. I hope you have all remembered to do the right thing, to commemorate and respect Jesus' life with kindness and humility. And that, of course, means keeping in line with his spirit and the meaning of his journey. Compassion can't be left out, and that extends to everybody, including other living beings, especially those who are innocent and defenseless. It is quite sad that some of us celebrate the life of a good and decent man with the slaughter of beautiful, sweet, innocent animals, masses of them at that, who are defenseless. It is very important, regardless of your theological perspective, whether you believe that Christ really rose from the dead or not, that you keep everything in context with what he represented. He was here for a short time, but he promoted empathy and equality for everybody. He was always seen protecting children and animals whom he loved very much, and asked people to stop sacrificing lambs and animals at the temple. Despite what train of thought the masses may have encouraged you to follow, please remember that it came from spiritually unenlightened people who didn't understand and don't understand the word of special individuals like Christ. Conventional thought has often been established by uneducated, backward peasant people. But I'm not here on a clerical mission to lecture you, so I'll get back on topic. It just will be unfair and tragic to celebrate life with killing of innocents. I'm sorry about the state of my voice. My sinuses are very blocked. I'm a little bit congested in my sinuses at the moment and my throat croaky. I apologise in advance about the not so attractive sound. So what I wanted to address is, even though I said my channel is not going to be predominantly about Chantal and Nader, and even though I'm going to incorporate video, but right now I'm looking like a scrubber. And to be quite honest, I'm a little bit out of stamina. I don't feel like getting ready, so I'm. Let's not punish the viewers with the visuals. Let's spare them the torture. Back on topic though, there were a couple of things I wanted to address which have come to my attention about Nader El Shami. First of all, I kind of felt a little bit bad for him when I was watching one of his live broadcasts but in replay, and I realised just how negative the comments in his live chats are. None of which is not deserved, of course. He has brought this upon himself. It has nothing to do with Foodie Beauty and drawing negative attention to him. His words and action speak for themselves, and people are reacting to his words, to his attitude toward others, and to his level of being unkind. Negative behavior is going to attract negative thoughts and reactions. It's only fair play. So it was a little bit difficult for me, having the compassionate nature that I do. I'm not trying to toot my horn. I'm just saying that I normally feel for others. It was a little bit difficult to try and remind myself, this guy is a very bad man. Don't feel bad for him. It's just a matter of time before he lunges and lashes out at others. As I started to watch his broadcasted streams on replay a little bit about Monty, I have this to say. I'm not sure what you're talking about, Nader, when you refer to a kinship with African people in general. I don't know how racist you are, but I'm aware that people in all parts of the world are racist, even toward individuals from their own country, let alone residents of the continent that they belong to. You might be fairer in complexion compared to other Egyptians, but I know for a fact that even they can be very discriminating toward foreigners. And a person from another country is definitely a stranger, a foreigner, regardless of the fact he might be from the same continent as us. So at least a portion of Egyptian people are racist toward other Africans. Look, I had a relationship with an African man, and I know firsthand about how darker humans of the African continent are treated in Egypt by natives that do make fun of and look down on people with darker complexion. In India, it is very much about class, but also about complexion. So the darker people from the same nation become a target for lighter individuals. You can't deny discrimination based on complexion. Egyptian people look very different from other Africans. That, for example, Somali, Sudanese and Ethiopians, the facial structure and everything about them is completely different. I know races have mixed within different countries and there've been different cultural influences with travelling and trade, but overall, the Northern Africans look very, very different. The culture is also very different. So please, Nader, don't adopt a supposed oneness with the whole of Africa. Your racism argument is not valid. Egyptians, just like other people of the world, can be very racist toward darker ethnicities. I'm a European, but as a Southeasterner, I relate more to people like the Lebanese and Israelis because our culture and everything about us is a lot more alike. We have no identifying points with the Northerners, such as the Polish, Hungarians and Austrians, undeniably. Also, Nader, you're upset that Monty is making fun of you. I haven't watched his videos, so I can't comment. But what about you making fun of Fudi Beauty so many times and talking horribly about her? You might say, yeah, I want to answer to some of the things that she's saying, but you got dressed up in her clothing and mocked her. And as I said, you held up her undergarments with gloves, mocking her, degrading her, demeaning her, humiliating her. You were imitating her while you were dressed up as her. That is the ultimate form of absolute mockery, satirizing and degradation. Also, regarding the allegations of people stealing your work, I have news for you. As long as you are in the public domain, people are allowed to comment and critique your work. It is a fair comment use rule that applies in different forms, but throughout all the countries, all jurisdictions, and in general, internationally, it is permissible. Whether you are an author, a filmmaker, a producer of an artwork, or even food, whatever it is, people are allowed the use of fair comment. Not sure what you're saying about copyrights, but as long as a person is making genuine commentary in relation to your content, that is very much legit and permissible. I also don't know where you got this unwritten rule from, where a user is not allowed to broadcast while you're live streaming and steal your work, because he's not stealing it and presenting it as his own content. He is commenting along the way about your material. So even satire is applicable and legit. Just check out the laws. Is Didi filling you up on legal issues? Because if she is, she's got it completely wrong, and she's not exactly a legal aid counsel. Furthermore, where is your logic when you're saying that by Monty broadcasting your material while it's in progress, he is stealing viewers because otherwise they would come and watch you? No, they wouldn't, because even if he lifted it after it was pre-recorded or after your stream had finished and he was commenting along the way, people would still choose to view your content through his platform. It doesn't matter when this was done, whether it was during live progress or replay, they still would choose Monty to watch it through because they're interested in his comment, in what he has to say, rather than your raw material. And some people don't want to support you for various reasons, including the fact that you have shown aggressive and violent behavior toward other people. Simple as that. Where is the logic, honestly, in all your comments and what you're saying? You're clearly upset and you're not applying any common sense. You're never going to be able to silence critics. It is there to stay. It is part of a healthily functioning human society, and that's why these rules are in place. Good luck in going after anyone. You're not going to get too far. It's called freedom of speech, and as long as it's not disparaging with ill intent somebody, you can't do anything about it. And even if there was ill intent involved and defamation, it's a very difficult case to prove. If you want to pursue it legally, you better have a lot of cash because you're going to need it. That's a cheap and nasty swing to make, using goggles there and saying, or perhaps just hinting, that you are capable of making fun of Monty. We very well know that you're very capable of bullying and making very disparaging content toward other people, because we have seen you do that with Foodie Beauty. And that's the irony of it all. You do it, but when somebody else, as much as passes a little bit of a critique to you, you just freak out and go through the roof. Calm down, El Shami. You better be ready to take what you give. And making fun of somebody's eyewear is the least funny element, because there are so many things in you that people could mock and make fun of. Don't push your limits and your luck. Don't tempt fate, mate, because there's a lot of shit that could come out if people were about to handle you as a stock laughable character. Before you judge anybody else's appearance or personality, take a close scrutiny at your own. Look at yourself in the mirror and examine yourself from all perspectives and angles. Pretty comical and inappropriate, isn't it, that somebody of your caliber of ethics and character is coming after other people's?
I don't act like kids.
Come again? Mental, emotional, and moral maturity is not exactly what defines you, Nader.
And when you try to make fun of me, first, put picture of me beside picture of you. And see how you can make fun of me. See what you got. Maybe you have green eyes, I don't have. Maybe you have long blonde hair. Maybe. So, don't go that way. I thought I have my glasses, but I'm not going like you. Can I? Oh, you don't know me. I'm for me until next year. Calm down. Focus. Do the right thing.
Because you always do what is right, don't you, Ashami? Also, before you provoke and challenge anybody to outdo you in appearance, I'm not going to be too cruel. All I'm going to say to you is, it isn't much of a competition or a feat to beat, is it? You're the only one who needs to calm down and sit down right here, because you've been pumping out rubbish that is very bullying and harmful to other people for a long time now. What is it? Has it been a year yet? But yeah, just shut up. I think you got your wires crossed, pal. You're saying that Monty once said, out of respect, he's not going to stream at the same time as one of the other reactor channels. I'm not sure if it was French Fried Girl or if it was the other lady. I forget her name. Doesn't matter, because I don't really watch people all that much. I don't have the time to watch everybody. Well, that was out of solidarity to somebody who is making fair comment to something that is in public domain. What I'm saying is that he didn't want to clash and compete with another person who is critiquing, who is commenting on somebody else's allegations, material, uploads, whatever it is. First of all, don't even compare yourself to music, you know, saying if I was a music creator, wouldn't you take my work out of your video? You are not creating, Nader. You're just going at the front of a camera and either mocking people or cooking your dinner that you're going to have with Diddy and then streaming it. That's not too, it doesn't take too much creativity to do all that. But anyway, back to the point. Monty was saying that he doesn't want to clash with somebody else who's doing similar work to what he's doing, which is fair commentary, critiquing stuff that is in public knowledge, public domain, because he's allowed to do that. You are not somebody who is critiquing somebody else's work, therefore he doesn't owe any solidarity to you, and especially he doesn't owe solidarity to somebody who is an abuser and threatens the safety of other humans and living beings, period. I'm not sure which part you don't understand, but obviously you're not a very bright spark, are you, Nader? And as far as the man's appearance is concerned, and you're saying he's not handsome, honestly, please go and fix your teeth. That's your first starting point you need to work at. And after that, we've still got a lot of work to do before you can even place yourself on a scale to compete with other people. Don't go there. Just don't friggin' go there, Nader. I can't vouch for anybody's character because I don't know anybody well enough, but Honestly, just about every person is bound to be better than you in values, in ethics, behavior, attitude, and etiquette. And as far as your outlook about your appearance is concerned, I'm not sure who has made you have that ego boost and to place high tickets on yourself, high tags on yourself. I'm here to make you eat some humble pie and to remind you that you are in no position to challenge any other guy on his appearance. So sit down. Everybody looks better than you, including Bozo the Clown, red nose and all. The opinion of uneducated, toothless, low-class women who follow you does not count. I'm not sure why they think you look as hot as Johnny Depp, Brad Pitt, or Billy Zane at his best, because to me, these are hot guys. And even they are humble about their appearance. This gentleman here is more appealing than you. Let me make things clear. While I believe in freedom of speech and pointing out what isn't right, even making fun of it, and yes, why not even satirizing, there are channels I do not agree with their content who are of extremely offensive nature and are also bullies themselves. So how dare you come online and target somebody for being a creep when you're just as bad as them? I'm not saying Monty's channel is like that, not at all. But there are some who are out there and don't deserve to give them support or solidarity. So I'm sorry, Monty, I don't know who exactly you support, but I'm sure there are people among your peers that I do not approve of, and I wouldn't give them the time of day or worry about clashing with them. But I suppose you want to be on good terms with everybody and play the game where you're not going up against anybody else. Yes, I would never even bother to give him a second glance or a thought or any sign of respect, because they are very unethical, cheap, even it's cheap and even cheaper than the behavior of Nader. So like I said, you're no better off to be in a place to be looking down on anybody else and coming down hard on them, because you're just as nasty and even nastier than Jerry Springer, attendees, guests, whatever the hell you want to call them. I'm sorry, whoever doesn't like what I have to say, you can take a walk around the block and give yourself a moment to calm down, but that's just the way of it. Back to Nader for a moment. You claim that people watch those particular reactor channels because of you, not because of their content. While I agree that there's a proportion, maybe even a high one, that does watch because they like the controversy, the train wreck, and to watch what's going on with you. I mean, even I am curious to see what's happening, right? Watching commentary or reading the critique about someone else's work is not the same as actually reading the original concept, the original material. So you got your wires a little bit confused. Viewing a film and reading a review is not the same thing. I'm not sure what is so difficult for you to understand. Just saying. Yeah? Your ridiculous comment that when you're a child, if you don't drink milk, you're stunted. Let me bring you up to date with the real facts. You're not meant to be drinking another species' milk, because little cows take what their mothers provide for them so they can turn into bigger animals who weigh tons. On top of that, milk by cows contains more than 60 hormones, which are detrimental and destructive to your health, apart from the fact that dairy also produces mucus and inflammation in your body. And I could really go on about many other reasons as to why drinking another species' milk is not intelligent. On top of that, we were nomads before and roamed. We didn't farm animals, and therefore it's not natural for us to be drinking another species' milk. We picked berries, fruit, nuts, whatever we found around the way as we roamed the earth, and we ate it. Why all of a sudden, when it comes to dairy and things like that, it doesn't suit you or other people to revert to our more archaic existence. But when it does suit you, you return back and revert to caveman days when we went out and speared everybody to death and ate the flesh of others. Let me remind you, when we were prehistorical, we also were very much cannibalistic. And there are societies who exist in the world today who are also cannibalistic. That doesn't justify anything that is wrong. Back to science and to facts. We're not meant to be drinking other species' milk. That was a human convention invented by peasants who were uneducated and not very intelligent. So what are you suggesting, Nader? That you drank your milk and therefore you developed into a very advanced human being? Because as far as I or anybody with reasonable rationale and judgment can tell, your mind and your ethics as well as your etiquette are very stunted. Don't go there, bud. It doesn't suit you. It doesn't serve your best interest to visit that argument. Sorry. I know a lot of things you can't. End of quote. That's exactly what you said to Monty. You don't know many things at all, Nader. You come across as very ignorant. Apologies about bursting your little bubble there. Please, for the love of man, Nader, stop pointing your pen at us. Nobody wants you pointing anything of yours at them. Facts, 100%. You suggest that Monty doesn't have the mentality to be able to deal with what you have to throw at him, but you are equipped with the capacity to deal with the critique other people have for you? Yeah. Right. And on a final note, not everything is about views and money. I'm never going to make big views or cash out of YouTube, but here I am speaking up against you and everything that is wrong because that's what I feel like doing. Because that's right and because that's what I'm all about.
You cannot make every single person your way. No. It doesn't work. This is not life. What's clear, right? Wrong. Since you're kids, without talking, you know.
What is ethically right or wrong hasn't previously concerned you, so stop pretending you're of a morally high ground. Anyway, guys, that's all I had to say about the great Dracula Nosferatu. I'll catch you in the next episode. Thank you for stopping by. Much love and best wishes to you all.